Hey guys, Andre Mizzle here. You know, for a long time, there were a lot of things that was holding me back. Fear, you know, the fear of doing the things that I know I needed to do. Now, there are a lot of people out there who start businesses who genuinely, genuinely don't know what to do. I had, you know, I didn't really have that problem because I knew what I needed to do. The only problem I had was I was afraid to do it. To give you an example. A lot of what I've done over the last few years has been online. Okay, so I got all of my customers, my clients, everything I acquired through social media marketing. Because I learned a few fundamentals, I learned how to acquire a customer online. So I thought, you know what, I'm okay, that's all I was going to do. I basically settled and sunk into my comfort zone. What I really needed to do was go out there and look for business. For example, in my one debt management company. So what that would comprise of or entail is actually going out to small businesses and retailers, because I've got retail experience, and going to explain and sell to them how my services would benefit them, their employees, and ultimately their business and their bottom line. So I knew I needed to do that, but I was afraid because I didn't want to get out of my comfort zone. And the problem with fear is fear actually or eventually stops you from acting. And one of the other things that fear produces is procrastination. It's amazing how when we know what we need to do, you know, you need to pick up the phone and make that appointment. Don't send an email, pick up the phone, guys. Okay? Successful people, they phone and they go and meet face to face, okay? So, you know, because I was afraid, and as I was saying, the fear starts to develop and gives birth to procrastination. So now we actually refrain from doing what we know we should be doing. And then we find all of these other priorities which just pop up out of nowhere. Attending to email, social media, working on the website or branding, whatever it may be. And we do everything else except what we need to be doing. Okay. So I know it's a tough one, and for many of us out there, you know, my comfort zone or our comfort zones are different, or we have different fears at least. Okay. Our level of comfortability with regards to doing what we need to do is different. So for me, what's difficult for me may not be difficult for you. You know, maybe easy for you. And what's you know, easy for you may be difficult for me. So my point is, we know what we need to do, and the only way to get across that and to get the results, and a lot of the results, I don't want to sound cliche, but trust me guys, the magic really does happen outside of your comfort zone. So we often know what we need to do, and the things that we need to do is absolutely 120% the things that you don't want to do, that you are afraid to do. So I want to urge you today, make sure that you are doing the things that you are afraid of doing. Okay, now I know, for example, with regards to sales, not everyone is a natural salesman, and I've spoken about this before. But, you know, in that case, you can be smart about it, and you're going to have to hire someone. So maybe you're going to have to get out of your comfort zone. And if you really don't want to do that, then you need to go out there. You're at least going to need to go out there and find someone to do it for you. Okay? But the whole principle of what I want to talk about, or what I'm trying to get across to you, is that you need to get out of your comfort zone. And the only way you're going to conquer fear and procrastination and all of that is to do the exact thing that you're afraid of doing. Okay, so whether it's making that appointment, going to see this person, or asking that question. Remember, if you never ask the question, the answer is always going to be no. I just did that on my forehead. I remember because we attended, Alan and myself attended a real estate seminar last year, and they literally wanted us to write ask on our foreheads. And the point was, if you never ask, the answer is always going to be no. And I know rejection is, it's probably I can make a whole series on rejection, but that's difficult because we take it personally. And you know, one thing entrepreneurship will teach you, whether you like it or not, is you're gonna have to develop thick skin and a lot of resilience. You're gonna have to, because you're gonna hear a lot of no's, okay? So, but just don't worry about that because it's part of the process. But essentially guys, get out of your comfort zone, go out there and do the things that you know you should do, but you're not wanting to do. Otherwise, you're not really gonna grow, okay?